Integration by Parts, Level 5. Alright, in this fifth video, we are essentially going to go over three different examples, demonstrating all the techniques learned from the previous four videos. The only difference is that we are going to work with definite integrals, as opposed to indefinite integrals, which were emphasized in the previous four videos. Okay, before we dive in, let's combine the formula for integration by parts with part two of the fundamental theorem of calculus. So evaluating both sides of the first form of the integration by parts formula from A to B, and assuming that f prime and g prime are continuous, we go ahead and combine it with the second part of the fundamental theorem of calculus. Doing that, we obtain the following formula to evaluate definite integrals while using the integration by parts formula. The integral from a to b of f of x times g prime of x dx is equal to f of x times g of x evaluated from a to b minus the integral from a to b of g of x times f prime of x dx, or written in another form as the integral from a to b of u dv is equal to u times v evaluated from a to b minus the integral from a to b of v du. It's essentially the same idea. We find the integral or antiderivative of a function, and then we evaluate it using the limits of integration. All right, let's try the first definite integral. Evaluate the integral from 0 to pi of x times sine of 3x dx. Okay, we notice that we have a product of two functions. So this integral is a perfect candidate to use integration by parts to find its integral. We first need to select our u and dv functions. In this case, we set u equal to x and dv equal to sine of 3x dx. Like always, we want our u to be a function that is easily differentiable and at the same time, a much simpler function. Likewise, our dv should be a function whose integral is easily found. So taking the derivative of u with respect to x, we obtain 1. And solving for du, we obtain the following. Next, we take the integral of dv to find v. So the integral of sine of 3x dx is equal to negative 1/3 times cosine of 3x. Having obtained all of our required functions, we substitute them into the integration by parts formula. So doing that yields the following. Next, we simplify the expression in the first term and factor out negative 1/3 from the integral on the right. Next, we find the integral of cosine of 3x and obtain 1/3 times sine of 3x. Next, we simplify both terms and evaluate it from 0 to pi. Substituting the limits of integration, we have the following. We can simplify the terms of the left bracket by noticing that cosine of 3 pi is equivalent to cosine of pi, which is equal to negative 1. In the same manner, sine of 3 pi is equivalent to sine of pi, which reduces to 0. The terms in the right bracket reduces to 0 because 0 times any number is equal to 0. And sine of 3 times 0 is equivalent to sine of 0, which simplifies to 0. Simplifying the expression, we have that the final answer is equal to pi over 3. Alright, let's try the next one. Evaluate the integral from 0 to 1 of x times 5 to the power of x dx. Once again, we have an integral that contains a product of two functions. So we use integration by parts to find its integral. We are going to let u equal x and dv equal to 5 raised to the power of x. Having done that, we take the derivative of u with respect to x and obtain the following. Then we solve for du. Next, we take the integral of 5 to the power of x dx and obtain 5 to the power of x over the natural log of 5. Now that we have all the required functions, we substitute them into the integration by parts formula as follows. We simplify the left term. Then we factor out 1 over the natural log of 5 from the integral. And then we find yet again the integral of 5 to the power of x dx, which is equal to 5 to the power of x over the natural log of 5. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the following. And now we evaluate it from 0 to 1. So doing that, we obtain the following expressions. The terms in the left bracket signifies as follows. And the terms in the right bracket signifies as follows. Remember, any number raised to the power of 0 is equal to 1. Finally, we add like terms and simplify. The final expression of the integral is equal to 5 over the natural log of 5 minus 4 over the natural log of 5 squared. Alright, let's try the final integral. Evaluate the integral from 0 to 1 of the quantity x squared plus 1 times e to the negative x dx. Alright. This integral will require multiple applications of the integration by parts formula, mainly because of the e to the negative x term and the second order polynomial. So we will use the tabular method for this one. So we create two columns, In one column, we will list u and its derivatives, and in the second column, we will list dv and its integrals, or antiderivatives. So we are going to let u equal x squared plus 1, and continuously take its derivative until it reduces to 0, as follows. In the same manner, we will successively find the integral of e to the negative x until we match the number of rows from the differentiation step. So doing that, we have the following. Finally, it's just a matter of pairing up the terms and multiplying diagonally down to the right. Make sure you take into consideration the alternating signs. They are always positive, negative, positive, negative, and repeats in that order. Include them as a third term that has to be multiplied along with the derivative and the integral functions. So you have a total of three terms that have to be multiplied by each other. Once we take the signs into consideration, we have the following. Next, we factor out a negative e to the negative x term and obtain the following. Now we evaluate it from 0 to 1. The terms in the left bracket signify as follows. And the terms in the right bracket signifies as follows. So the definite integral is equal to negative 6 times e to the negative 1 minus 3, or written in another form as negative 6 over e minus 3, and yet in another form as the quantity negative 6 plus 3e over e. Alright, in our next and final video on integration by parts, we will go over examples that require the application of multiple integration techniques.